Hi, so welcome back, guys. We're going to be talking about a concept called as international human rights law. We spoke about human rights already. I'm just going to take you through the international human rights law part. I don't have to tell you, it's universally applicable everywhere. Now we're talking about at the state level or at the nation level. That's where we're talking about for this. International by itself tells you that it's at an international platform. Now the reason I'm talking about this is because a lot of times students don't understand what international human rights means. Is it different from human rights at all? It's the basis. We can say that human rights is the foundation and international human rights is a building that you're going to build on it. The special thing about international human rights is there is a concept called as the doctrine of sovereignty. Now, this is what I talk about, the doctrine of sovereignty. The doctrine of sovereignty is a concept where every country in the world is a sovereign country, is a country which is independent, is a country which is supreme in its own. So when somebody is supreme, you can't have somebody from the outside come and tell you how to run your country. It's like this. You've got a family of four. You've got a head of the family who is either your father or your mom. And for you to get somebody on the outside, maybe a friend or a neighbor, come and tell you how you should be running your family is not acceptable, right? Similarly, for anybody on the outside to tell a state how to run the country or how to treat its people is what human rights actually is, right? So if a state fails to protect the individuals who are staying inside the vicinity or within the territory of the state, what do you do then? Do you keep your mouth shut and not say anything against that state? Do states intervene in the matter? Yes, they do. The country that we know intervenes most of the times is the US. We call it the superpower. But it goes against the doctrine of sovereignty, because I'm telling a particular state or a particular nation how to run its country, how to treat its people. This is also a problem we face because we don't have a global government to protect it. We have the UN. But the most of the things that the UN does is not legally binding on the states. Only what the Security Council of the UN does is specifically binding. So when we talk about international human rights, the line or the area is fairly gray, because a country has a domestic law of its own, and that domestic law has been passed by the government. If you are to undermine that domestic law, you're going to undermine the government, you're going to undermine its people, and you're going to end up being an enemy on a world platform. So when you talk about international human rights as a concept, you need to handle it very sort of delicately, because like other aspects of law, it's not a black and white. It depends from situation to situation. It depends from the kind of relationship you have. Like, for instance, I would like to believe that India has very good relations with, say, for instance, Japan at this moment. So if there are any suggestions we are to give them, we know that it may not backfire on us. But if there are other countries which might be an enemy state to India, for us to give them suggestions of how to run their country or how to treat their people, will obviously not get accepted. So when you talk about international human rights law, it is a law that is applicable among states. It is a law that is exercised at the international platform, but it is also a law that you need to exercise very carefully, because it might interfere with the doctrine of sovereignty or the domestic law of that particular country. However, there are two situations which are an exception to the two international human rights law going against the doctrine of sovereignty. That is the abolition of slavery and the protection of minorities. These are two situations where every world leader has come together and has passed a law, has signed a sort of a document that they will not engage in it, because this is, it goes, it is, inhumane. So then it moves outside the purview of human rights, and the whole point of studying human rights goes to the dogs.